ends of those the spectrum, that the crazy sex and this and that, and that, once that goes away, or once it starts to diminish, then you see the real energy of what somebody is, the kindness of people, civility, kindness, truthfulness, credibility, empathy, all of those things that are really important, which is crazy because there's so many dudes that listen to the podcast in a way, and they have those things, those things of kindness and civility and generosity and all of that, and they do shitty with women. But what they don't understand, it's not because they don't have the Porsche or the motorcycle or that. It's because they don't value the one thing that is more scarce on earth than anything else, which is truth and credibility and empathy and things that are without those things. I mean, like you could be dating a Victoria's Secret's model and not be with her because she's fucking your dad. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like her look. Right. I mean, I had to use that as an.
What's
as
her baseline?
You're bad. So I let more things slide because I'm attracted to you. But there's still love is conditional. Right. There are conditions to every relationship, even if it's, yo, could you just not fuck my dad? You know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
it is.
Dude, great sex can be learned, right? So, you know, within a relationship, sex is going to get bad. You're going to learn the good stuff anyway. And two, you get everyone eventually looks normal. So no matter how hot she is, at some point you're going to go, oh, you just look normal now. And then they have to spice it up. Everyone's like, but that baseline of empathy and all that shit, that's, you want that to build on. You want to build on that.
But I think on a basis, there's a lot of dudes who are not successful with women, but they're not successful women because they don't have all these things. They're not successful for women because they don't feel like they have any real value. And because they don't think that they have any value, and I always say this to them, I'll say to them, I said, man, you know, I had the guy be like, I don't really, you know, women don't really, I don't really know how to, you know, what if I could clone you and you have another you as your best friend? And they go, oh man, that would be awesome. Oh, like so it's kind of a reflective way to look at how you see yourself. Like those things that you devalue, but you go, well, if I had that would be awesome. And then you when you flip that the other way to a woman that you're attracted to, or a man that you're attracted to, whatever, you're going, what you're basically saying is, I value this. So, and I'm human. All people, all human beings value that. You know, those things are important for everybody because they're more important than anything else. The six pack, the good looks, the this, the that. Though, if you don't have those things, I think we push those things so far back as opposed to understanding those are the most valuable things. If you have a friend or a partner or wife or husband that you can trust, that is more valuable than anything else, because being with somebody, having all kinds of possessions and money, and being with somebody you can't trust, you probably won't have those possessions.
Facts.
They're on the inside track.
If you're a good guy and you're funny and you just believe in yourself, look at me, man. My wife is a beautiful Asian woman who does way better than me. And I collect and make action figures. You know what I mean? Like,
That's cool as fuck. The action figure shit. I want to make Gundams.
Dude, I can get you. Let's do that podcast. I will get you. Yes. We're gonna really go left field here, but to that, like the suit, the abs, that gets you in the door. But just being a genuine good person, it's like, dude, they will deal. Women will, like,
keeps you there.
Yeah, and all the weird shit you hate about yourself ends up being the things that they like about you. I used to hide my action figures from girls. They'd come over. I took all the shit off. I didn't want them to know that I was into this. Yep. And this girl broke up with me because she came into my house unexpected, saw all my toys, and she went, I don't even know you. And I was like, get this. Like, we broke up. My wife, I go, listen, I'm always going to do comedy and I'm always going to collect toys. And she goes, well, those are the things I love about you. And I had never noticed that that's what was making me different and making me a little like that. So like those chinks in your armor are what make your armor. That's what makes you different and cool and great. Love that shit. Why am I doing this? I don't know why I'm going on this giant fucking thing of telling people to love themselves.
I think it's advice. A good thing to understand that the when you meet a woman, she doesn't know what your value is. You've been with you your whole lifetime. Mm-hmm. So nobody's a better expert on you than you. Now, if you don't know, if you know you and she just meets you, how does she learn who you are? You have to tell her. Now, you don't say, I'm this, I'm that, I'm loyal, I'm this, but just because the natural order of your every, like I said, that truth is it, who you are permeates everything that you do. And when she feels that confidence of the fact that I'm okay with this, I understand what my value is, then you're communicating to her that I know I have value. She has, how else, if she just meets you, even if she's known you for a year or 2 years, there's no way she knows you like you know you.
Right.
And right. But if you don't value what you have to offer, that will, no matter how valuable those things are, that will not come through. You literally will kind of, you'll give away, it'll be a tell that you don't think that you have value. You're telling her, mm-hmm, I don't, you know, your shoulders is curled, your head is not up, you don't, right. I mean, you hiding your action figures is to say, like you know, like when Andre hears it, you go, that's dope, right? And your lady, your wife goes, that's dope, but you were like, it's weird and I don't want to show right. anybody. So this girl comes in and she goes, I'm weird. You basically told her, I'm weird and I'm not the person, I'm not coming, which is exactly the reason why she should leave, because that situation, that kind of deceptiveness reads to women as unsafe.
Right.
Safety is everything. Right. Dishonesty is unsafe.
But a confident guy with action figures, they don't give a fuck. They're like, well, maybe I'm the weird one that I think this is weird. Right? You know, I mean, you're 100%.
And if you don't give a fuck about what people think because you've done the work to be the best version of yourself, then that comes through too. It's so crazy. It's like, you know, I always say with Harry, like Harry was like, oh, it was like, Harry lost like, what, 60 pounds now, Harry?
About that, yeah.
Hey, nice.
About 60.
About 60 pounds. But I mean, you know, he's more. But I mean,
when I met my girl before I lost the weight, ironically. So I met my girl as a fat dude. So the weight loss has nothing to do with. And also, even at my peak, when I was like, I mean, with women, I had a roster of like 5 or 6. None of that was through the weight loss. So I was still like, it was the confidence and the ability to make the.
It was because he was working at being the best version of himself. He knew that was at the end of the tunnel, and so he had the confidence so that when you called on something, but I'm getting there, I'm working to get there, it's attainable, and that even gives you confidence. You know, we never get to the place that we want to be exactly where. I mean, that's, perfection is always unattainable. I would say perfection is unattainable because as you move closer to it, it moves further away from you in terms of how you perceive perfection. As you get closer, it's like the Swiss cheese. There's more holes in Swiss cheese than when you get closer to it, you know, so it's always. But if you're an individual who is willing to recognize mistakes and flaws and willing to work on them to fix them, there's nothing more perfect than that. You can't ask a human being to be more perfect than that.
The flaws make you to exactly what you're saying with the
Young Man School 202. Better hear what I've got to say because you won't get it again.
I'm not an alpha male. I'm not a beta male either. I'm just a better man. Better man. Better man. Put your happiness first, because if you don't, they won't.